15. Thanks for staying tuned to your station, the African Independent Television, and welcome to your program, Sacred to Watch Africa. It's another bright and beautiful Saturday, and we're happy we're here to present and bring you this program. Today, we'll be looking at the news that has been going on during the week, talking about the Amnesty International reports on human rights that allegedly indicted the Nigerian military in terms of abuse of the rights of some citizens of Nigeria. A lot of things have been said about it. So many opinions are flying left, right, and center. But we really want to look at it dispassionately from the angle of what really is the situation, what happened, and how possible can that report be true, and is it true? We're starting up this discussion because it's very, very important. We remember that one of the reasons why some Western countries, particularly the United States of America, refused to release arms to fight the insurgency would do it was said that because of rights or abuse of rights that it wasn't given. And so, but subsequently we have seen a military that has done his job diligently, that have been able to gain confidence, and weapons have been sold to Nigeria and assistance have been rendered. But with this report, a lot of things are begging for quests for answers, and that is where we've come in to look at it, because the war against insurgency and terrorism in Nigeria must be won, but we must look at the issue about the report. Is it true? What is the situation? During the week, one of the people that actually made the presentation spoke about it was a center, my brother who had been on this program before, Philip Agbese, addressed a press conference to state the opinion, the mind of the center concerning that report. Let's bring you his comment, then I will introduce my guest in the studio or with me so we can talk about it.
Amnesty International has, however, taken the ridiculous to a new low this week with the release of a report which it openly sided with terrorists, insurgents, separatists, and fifth columnists while treating Nigerians as enemies. The intention in Nigeria is to blackmail the Nigerian Armed Forces security institution into not being able to discharge their statutory duties.
The group says it disagrees with Amnesty's claim on the clampdown on press freedom.
I believe that journalism is a profession that is formed within certain ethics, and there are regulatory bodies for that. So for individuals who masquerade themselves overnight in the name of social media activism to peddle falsehood, I think a clampdown on such an individual is not a threat to the to freedom anywhere.
It also thinks Amnesty has taken sides with persons and groups.
Welcome back. Yeah, you heard him there talking about that report. There are different opinions. Many people that believe that report needed to be looked into critically, and that is where we fall in. I have in the studio with me already my brother Quarren Tyson. Quarren Terrence is a Global Amnesty assessor. He is here with us in the studio to look at this issue on this report. Terrence, this is not the first time Amnesty is coming up with reports on this issue. Some people have said that why is it that at the time when it seems that either the Nigerian security or the Nigerian military seems to be making headway in the fight against criminality and insurgency, a report comes to indict them? Why do you think it's happening?
You know, if you look at the report that Amnesty has brought up,
yeah,
and you follow the activities closely, as long as Nigeria is concerned, you see no difference at all from what they have been bringing up. And that is why we, at the Global Amnesty Watch, we feel that what is happening with the Amnesty International is that people are sponsoring them against the Nigerian state. Or we even suspect that the sponsors of Boko Haram are the people that have paid Amnesty International to come and be giving such reports. Because we at Global Amnesty Watch, we work closely with the security people, and we have spoken with the chief of army staff, and when we went to army headquarters, they have a human rights desk, and anytime they are to try even their personnel that have gone around against the human rights violations. They even call us to come and be part of it. We sit paru pasu with the military authorities and we look at their activities, how they have gone against the human rights convention rights and look gone against the laws of this country and see how they have been able to tackle these issues. They even go beyond their ethics of punishing their personnel that have gone against human rights. Like you see the case of the crippled person. Look at the level they went. They even went beyond their laws, the way they have been able to indict those people, the way they have been able to punish those personnel. It even beyond the rules of engagement of the Nigerian military. But they did that because the military that is headed by Lieutenant General Boratai is seriously doing it in concert with the Human Rights Watch.
Okay. Viewer, this is a program, this topic, we want you to interact with us, we want you to send us message, communicate with us through, via our social media platform, as the Facebook fan page is there. Ask questions or send your views so we can take it up on this program, or our Twitter accounts. If you're not following us, follow us and send us a tweet so that we can talk with you. Or better still, use the email address and send us your views so that we can talk better with you. Yeah, you heard Philip Agbese talk there.
Yeah.
He actually vehemently talked about that those people, like you said here, may be sponsored. Do you agree with him?
Completely. I agree with him that there is a sponsorship. They're not just a sponsorship of those sponsoring the Boko Haram insurgency. They are sponsors that want this country to be divided. Our advice from the Global Amnesty Watch is that there are countries that want to be divided from other countries willingly. They should go and give them assistance. Like California wants to be divided from the United States of America. The Great Britain wants to leave the European Union. Why are they not going to help them leave the entities they want to leave? They come to Nigeria that wants to be united and strong and indivisible and wants to divide it. Because nothing happens in this country, and then the next thing, Amnesty International comes out to say that this human rights abuse has been committed, this one has been committed, this one has been committed, and they don't have proof to it. Like yesterday, I was terrified when I was watching channels in the morning. And then a lady came up on channels and said that the channels asked him how they confirmed that the bullets that kill people comes from the Nigerian army. And she boldly came to television to tell Nigeria that they do forensic to confirm it. Does Amnesty International have a lab in the Northeast, or do they carry dead bodies from the Northeast and take them to their labs in Europe to go and confirm it? These are the kind of ridiculous claims Amnesty International is bringing to divide the Nigerian state. They have completely gone against the Nigerian state. Confirming that they have turned into a state to fight against the Nigerian state.
Yeah. Okay. Now let's look at that report, because I went through the report myself.
I did.
The report to me, it's some people have said it's giving empowerment to even the insurgency, because but is it possible for you to fight these terrorists without some of these abuses they talked about? Is it possible for you to approach the terrorists that have been killing some people and be bombing and not abuse so-called rights?
Yes. As long as the Nigerian military, under the leadership of General Boratai is concerned, he has fought this battle of insurgency with the cardinal point of protecting the human rights. And he has done it successfully.
Now we'll talk about right. Is it the right of this insurgent, or the right of the ordinary?
The right of the Nigerian, the right of a human life, includes the right of the insurgency.
Okay, good.
They have never miam or killed an insurgent against the human rights convention laws. And from the what is, if you look at day four yesterday, from what is trending, they claim that Shakao even killed his spokesperson. It is a clear indication that Boko Haram are even killing themselves. Mm. They can even kill themselves and come and dump them on the line of their military. These are issues that have to be critically looked into. You don't just sit because you're Amnesty International and because you have been paid.
to bring out falsehood against our military. Our military, let me tell you, is the best military in this continent. That alone could even provoke those kind of instigative reports so that they would diminish the kind of integrity they have built for themselves. There are so many suspicions from where those reports are coming from. Because you cannot tailor one report to be coming up consistently for over 3 years. And now that the war on insurgents has been won, this thing is coming because we know that the sponsors only wants to use that report to be able to diminish what we have successfully done. And that is why this report is coming up. Because there is no way you convince anybody now that Boko Haram is existing in this country. Where Boko Haram is existing, they have run to a neighboring country to regroup and come back, which is where the military is strategizing to make sure that they don't invade our territories again. Now this report is coming up. Where are their business coming up? Where are they happening? Because we just saw a report, we just saw a live report where the military has indicted their own personnel that have gone against the human rights abuse. So who will be exempted? The military has come out to tell us that they have never ever killed against their convention rights. So where is the report coming from? And if you look at the report they released, look at the report they released last year. Did you see any difference in
it? No.
So is it that nothing has changed in the warfare? That is the question.
Yeah. Some people had said, could this be part of, you know, a plan to make sure that, you know, because just a few days ago, or a week, the president of the United States spoke with the president of Nigeria on phone and made promises that Nigeria will be supported this time in tangible terms with equipment and all that. And just a few days after that promises, this report is coming. Some people are saying, could it be that this is a report to prevent such support from coming to Nigerian armed forces?
Yeah, if you look at the, we are from Global Amnesty Watch, we are going to bring out our own report very soon, and people will be able to see the reality of so many things that have been covered up. Let me tell you that the war that have been won by this administration came as a shocker to the people that have been sponsoring these groups. We even did a protein report on this issue, and we asked questions that people that came from the Northeast, what has been their efforts to the resolution of this crisis? What has been the efforts of the international community to the resolution of this crisis? But if you look at the trend that has been happening of recent, now that the war has been won, if you notice, the advisor on national security to the United Kingdom was with the Vice President yesterday. The U.S. Chief of Army Staff on Africa was in the villa yesterday. That is to tell you that now we have caged these people. Every nation of this world is coming to Nigeria for the rebuilding process. Now the sponsors are shivering. They know that their investment has been lost. The only people that are falling prey for them now is their sponsors, the Amnesty International. And it is so saddened that Amnesty are ridiculing themselves to this level, that now they have come to deliver a report and all the non-governmental organizations have told the reports to share it because they know where they are coming from. Nobody takes them serious. And it is a shame that they have reduced this kind of organization in Nigeria to that level. We advise them that what they are looking for is begging in other nations. Can they give this kind of report to the U.S. Marine? Can a U.S. Marine or a United Kingdom soldier be brought down? And then there's a retributive attack and you give that kind of report? You and I know when a UN Marine is gone down in battle. You and I know when a British Army is gone down in battle. You know what happens. But every day, day in, day out, Boko Haram are ambushing our military people. They are killing them. One report has come from Amnesty International. So now, the human rights abuses that are protecting only goes to North State actors.
Okay. Now I have a message here from Obi Chinonso. He said, your guess is biased. Nigerian army killed IPOB members who were rallying in support of Donald Trump in Port Harcourt. Today they are denying it. I was in Port Harcourt live and saw the killings.
Okay. Chinonso is saying he stood in the line of action.
he was in Port Harcourt live.
What he doesn't know about the people, these separatists, what he doesn't know about them is that they come out to the street to achieve a purpose. Our military does not carry gun to go to the street to kill the people that are protesting. The military is the last line of action. If you come out on the street to protest, you meet the civil defense, you meet the police, the military are the last line of action. So how did he know that the people that went to kill down are not even the IPOB themselves? Because they came out to make a statement. So if we go to stop the protest, it is possible that out of their mischief, they might have done that themselves. Because the security personnel cannot kill you in the process of protest and then allow your body to be lying down there. If in the process of protesting or in the process of combat and somebody is shot down, they are always evacuated. So for somebody to have been shot and left on the ground, obviously might have even come from the IPOB. These are mischievous makers. Calm down.
Okay.
Nobody will want today to wake up to go and build another AIT studio and prefer to burn this AIT studio down first. Anybody that wants to do that is mischievous. So anything that comes out of that person, you should look at the mischief first.
Okay.
Because if you have gone through hard labor to develop this studio, you will not wake up one day to go out to burn it just because you want to go and build another one.
Yeah.
So if the IPOB are saying they need Biafra, must they destroy the country they want to call Biafra tomorrow? These are the questions. Those are the mischief.
Yeah, they said that they're having peaceful rally just to draw interest to the agitation. But the military feel that why should IPOB come out and cause problem? Don't you think that to them, they feel that they're defenseless, or the military is coming with live ammunition to attack them?
Are they sure what they were doing, what you watched in Port Harcourt, was that a peaceful protest? If you are protesting peacefully, do you have pebbles? Do you throw stones and pebbles against the security people that are guiding you to have a successful protest? They confronted the security personnel. The security personnel never confronted them. So for the military to have gone to where they are protesting, it's obvious that the protest was beyond the police and the civil defense. For you to see a military personnel where they are protesting, that protest has become violent. And we have the brigade of guards. These are not armies in the past. These are brigade of guards guiding all of us. They are the first people to confront them. And I'm telling you authoritatively, that if anybody died in the Port Harcourt protest, it was mischief for them themselves.
Okay, all right. Okay, let's come down a bit. You have talked about how the military tried to discipline their officers when they seems to go beyond the rules of engagement. But have you visited some of all these areas? I'm talking about global amnesty assessors, visiting maybe the northeast or the southeast to be able to see how this engagement, how they engage with the people they are to either to fight or to protect.
Yes, I have met everybody where there is crisis. I have been to the northeast. I have met with the general commander of Operation Lafayette Dole. I have been with the GOC of 7th Division, I have been with the GOC of 82 Division, I have been with the AIGs, I have been with the Civil Defense Commanders. We have discussed all the security personnel, they have human rights deaths. We've discussed side by side with the Convention on Human Rights Laws and the laws of our country. We know what is happening. And most of the time, when disciplinary actions are being taken against these personnel, they invite international NGOs to come and be part of it. So what I'm telling you from authority, because I have been part of the process. I am not assuming. I am not waiting on a publication to go and declare a report. I am telling you of an experience that I have live. I have discussed with these people. And let me be very honest with you. Because of the eyes that are on the military, both in Nigeria and internationally, they have even gone against their rules to deal with their pestilence.
Okay. Now, where do we go from here? Because this report has been released and people are saying that this could actually may jeopardize this the morale or the spirit of this is our Nigerian military in making sure that this fight is won. And is it possible to also protect the lives of people without infringing on the rights of the people?
Of course.
Okay.
The military has succeeded in doing that. And let me tell Nigerians that what Amnesty International is doing, they are not just doing it to the military. They are doing it to us, all Nigerians. If you look before we got to this level, they had already conspired with some prophets to even prophesy the division of this country. Because our military has been able to frustrate those prophecies, they have gone back to reports. Nigeria should be aware that Amnesty International is in this country to find a way and divide this country. That is their objective in Nigeria. Nothing more. There's no way an international NGO of repute that was sat and created like Amnesty International will come and be ridiculed in Nigeria just for some peanuts. You understand? That has been paid to them to do the report for the satisfaction of their sponsors. It is so, so despicable. Okay. The Nigerians should stand up because this is the time for us to fight for our unity.
Okay. Yeah, we're getting signal to go, and we must leave other programs to continue. But I just let me quickly just at Ekudina. He said okay, in a nutshell, he's asking if you are speaking on behalf of the Nigerian army.
I'm speaking on behalf of the Nigerian people.
Okay. All right. You say you have something to say.
Yes, I have something to say because today, one of the greatest patriots that has fought for the peace of this country, that has fought for the unity of this country, is celebrating his day today. I want to use this medium to enjoin Nigerians to celebrate Chief Philip Agbese. He has been a wonderful patriot that has gone around, has sacrificed a lot for the peace of this country. And such people needs to be celebrated. And today, all Nigerians, let's come out and celebrate such a wonderful patriot and shun the enemies that has come to divide us. We are going to put them to shame. We are going to ridicule them because we are going to win our wars, and we are going to come out united and stronger because we have a military that is the envy of the world.
Okay. Now I want to join you to say happy birthday to Philip Agbese. He has been a guest on this program. It's somebody we relate with closely. So happy birthday. I pray that God will strengthen you more and more. Somebody's asking here again before you will round up. He said, are you saying, is your guest trying to tell us that none of the Amnesty reports has ever been true?
None of the Amnesty reports can ever be true. How can one report be duplicated for 3 years? How can one report be duplicated for 3 years? Does that make sense to any Nigerian? Even common sense will tell you that they are being tailored by somebody, and the person is not even intelligent enough to even omit one aspect of the report. He keeps bringing it over and over and over. Even when the leadership of the military is changing, they are bringing the same report.
Okay, is it possible or is it not possible for the military to maybe take some bit of this report and look at it and see internally if there's any infringement?
We have already looked at the report collectively with the military and assess their activities in the combat field. You understand? We don't see where the report is effective.
Okay. Now I have another one. Yeah, in fact, you've been sending messages, and we must appreciate you. I have this one from Israel Ehije Akobo. He said the issue with some of us is that we Nigerians like unnecessary complaint. It's time we learn how to appreciate our military. By the time the saboteurs see that we love our military, they will find it difficult to pollute our minds.
It's true.
I think this person is agreeing with
you. No, it's true. If we don't stand up to protect our military and appreciate them, then we are not grateful people. This same military, in the process of defending our borders and integrity, have gone out to even solve the same problem right now in the Gambia. They have done it successfully and they are back. Even Gambians that are not Nigeria are celebrating our military. They're the most they have done to us here. All we do is to go and pay for reports to come and blackmail them. It will never work.
All right, we must leave for that program to continue. I will say thank you for joining us.
Nice. And, thank you so much.
We look forward to looking at this report again with the military, like you said. Yeah. Yes, if you're joining us, unfortunately, we have to leave. But keep your messages coming. We'll take it up with the military authority and with my guests in the studio to see how things can be done better than it is today. Until we come your way again next week, I will say bye for now and remain blessed.